in a few decades, we would all be fighting, quote, Christian fascists. Who was he, and why did he think this?
James Luther Adams was my ethics professor at Harvard Divinity School. He had spent the years 1935 and 1936 in Germany working with Dietrich Bonhoeffer in the Confessing Church, or anti-Nazi church, and eventually was picked up by the Gestapo and told to leave the country. He came back, and this was in the early 1980s when I was in seminary, and saw the articulation of this new political religion, this religion that talked about seizing control of mainstream denominations, as well as institutions, creating a parallel media empire through Christian radio and broadcasting, and ultimately taking control of the government itself. And he understood in a visceral way how when countries fall into despair, of course this began, it was the time that began the assault on the American working class, which has been accelerated and essentially left tens of millions of people within our own country dispossessed. He understood how demagogues use that despair. I mean, I think we could say there in many ways has been a kind of Weimarization of the American working class. And he saw what we were doing through globalization, what we were doing to our working class and our middle class, coupled with the rise of these so-called Christian demagogues as a frightening and toxic combination, which, if left unchecked, would destroy our democracy.
Your assessment of President Obama?
A disaster. A poster child for the bankruptcy of the liberal class. Somebody who, like Clinton, is a self-identified liberal, who speaks in the traditional language of liberalism, but has made war against the core values of liberalism, which is a concern for those people outside the narrow power elite. The tragedy, if tragedy is the right word, is that Obama, who made this Faustian bargain with corporate interests in order to gain power, has now been crumpled up and thrown away by these interests. They don't need him anymore. He functioned as a brand after the disastrous 8 years of George Bush. And what we are watching is an even more craven attempt on the part of the White House to cater to the forces that are literally destroying the United States, have reconfigured, are reconfiguring this country into a form of neo-feudalism. And all of the traditional, the pillars of the liberal establishment that once provided some kind of protection, and more importantly, a kind of safety valve, a mechanism by which legitimate grievances and injustices in this country could be addressed, have shut tight. They no longer work. And so we are getting these terrifying proto-fascist movements that are leaping up around the fringes of American society and have as their anger not only a rage against government, but a rage against liberals as well. And I would say that rage is not misplaced.